Imagine being able to stream on Twitch Vertical, because that's coming soon, on YouTube Vertical, which is already there, for a small portion of creators on TikTok, then on Facebook, then on Twitter, then any other website that allows you to input a stream key, all at the same time. Today, we're going to be checking out the ADEM streaming suite for OBS Studio. This is basically an all-in-one add-on for OBS Studio that gives you all the plugins necessary to have a multi-streaming machine. So yes, you do need to be familiar with OBS Studio and some of the plugins, but don't worry. If anything feels confusing, there will be links in the description to specific dedicated videos explaining those things. So let's get started. First things first, where do you get this add-on? By going to ADEM.tv and scrolling down, and immediately you'll see it right here. Download Streaming Suite for free. And it also tells you immediately that it does require OBS Studio version 32 or after that. I do feel like it's important to let you know that this is not a paid endorsement. You're not watching an ad. I did make a video where I tried their very first plugin for multi-streaming, and I used that in combination with StreamElements Ground Control, which is their multi-streaming like dashboard, but it was basically a mess. I needed to have Ground Control and OBS Studio open separately. So in that same video, I was like, oh, I see that ADEM has something called the Stream Suite. I need to test it. And that's what we're doing today. I always disclose when a video is a paid advertisement, and I also always disclose when a company approaches me to talk about something, even if it's for free. If it's your very first time using the Vertical plugin and the multi-stream plugin, it's actually going to run you through a setup wizard. You will not see this in this video because I already had those plugins installed. The installation is pretty simple. Just click next, next. And surprisingly, this also installs a couple of OBS plugins for you. Now, I already use most of those, but I don't mind the rest. So let's click next and next and next. Of course, if you have OBS open, you want to close that to continue. Since I'm recording with OBS, I'm going to do just that. Now, if you already had your OBS set up, it might jumble a bunch of stuff around. Do not panic, okay? You just need to tidy it up a little bit. But the goal here is to optimize your stream for multi-streaming. For example, on the right here, I can see that this is where my combined chat is going to be. Therefore, I do not need my singular Twitch chat to be on the left here. I can close it. Same thing for stream information. I know that this is going to be over there at stream info, and I'm going to be able to control the stream information for all of my platforms at once. So I can close this. And now we can really dedicate this left side for our vertical stream. Dragging this around, I can see that my sources and my scenes are here and my transition. All right, so let's set it to this. So game scene. Right now, I don't like the transition. I can set that to cut. Boom, that's fine. And then I can bring that all the way back. It collapses on itself, which is pretty nice. I'm sorry, right now my scenes are not gonna look like much because I actually lost a bunch of stuff on my hard drive. So my setup is not really ready right now. You know what? Let me put this and that. There we go. At least this will look half decent. Okay, there's no reason for my audio mixer to be huge like that. So let's bring this here and this one there. And it's simple. Here, this portal tab is for their app. This is a paid version, so we're not going to use it for this tutorial, but you can look into it. You could keep your chat here, but it's combined chat. So if chat is popping, I will probably want it to be bigger. So I can click, drag, and try to find a way to really set it apart. It's not really working. I'll just drop the activity here. Stream info is not something that you're going to be playing around all stream, so we can also just drop it here. It'll be a tab right next to activity. So I would probably keep it on activity and then do this, do that, set my mixer to this layout. And yeah, I think that's a decent layout right there. So all of your landscape live streams would be in the middle here. Your scenes, your sources, if you want to switch, do whatever you want. Your audio mixer in the middle, so you can control everything. Your controls right there. Activity, so whoever interacts, whether it's on YouTube, on Twitch, or Kick, it's gonna appear here in case you miss the alert. Your combined chat on the right, and then everything that has to do with portrait streams on the left. All right, let's connect to Twitch. Boom, authorize. And you can see my Twitch activity already appeared right there. It's pretty cool. Now we're gonna click on this button to connect the other ones. Let's go with YouTube. Okay, once you're connected, you're gonna see the little red thing appear here. And now my YouTube activity also shows up. Nice. Now I don't have a Kick account, so we're gonna skip that step, but all you have to do is just click on it and then authorize. Okay, so important step here is the stream info at the bottom here. That's where we put it. Well, I guess it's not super visible here, but let me drag it out just so you can see what it looks like. And then you can decide where you place it. I guess here wouldn't be that bad. The All tab means that you're going to put a stream title in a category and it's going to apply to all, or you can do it platform by platform. One thing to note is that for YouTube to save that information, you need to go live. So you cannot change your stream title and category in advance before going live on YouTube. You need to go live and then save here. Then it will take effect. And once you're done, you click Save All. And now one thing you might be asking is, what if I want to stream on TikTok? Now, you do need a stream key for that. And the way you can do it is by going to Settings, top left here, going to Output. And then from there, you can add a new output, click on Stream, then add TikTok, and enter the information you'll have on your TikTok Live Center. I've never had it. It's always been iffy to get it. They've always been pushing their own live studio, so yeah. But hey, if you're super lucky to have a stream key, this is where you would put it. And as you can see, there's way more than just Twitch, YouTube, and Kick. There's Trovo, you can stream on Twitter from here. Any other service that's going to give you a server address and a stream key, Facebook, and all that good stuff. That being said, we're actually missing a tab here, believe it or not. So if I go up there and I go to Docs, I'm looking for something called Outputs. There it is, right there. And as you can see, built-in stream main canvas, that's my Twitch. Built-in record. So if I want to record my landscape preview here, backtrack, it's that kind of shadow play feature that they have, virtual camera. So I have all those options. As you can see here, I have Twitch for my main canvas and I have options for my vertical stream, but I don't actually have YouTube. So I'm going to click on the plus, add a new stream. It'll be YouTube. And then from there, I can put my YouTube stream key. Now, something to note is that YouTube kind of switched where they put the stream key. It used to be at the bottom here, but now it's up there. You just click copy, there you go. And then here I can just paste and create output. So now I have my YouTube output. If I click okay, there you go. So if I wanna go live, all I have to do is click on those buttons and then boom, I'll go live. So my vertical YouTube stream is right there. So I would have to activate that if I want that, okay? That being said, if this is all too complicated and you don't necessarily want to have like a separate different preview with scenes and sources that you want to manage and this looks like a mess, you can just close all of that just like that. And then on YouTube, you have the option called dual stream, and this will automatically generate, as you can see here, a vertical stream. The thing is, it's automatic. So you don't get all the sweet options from OBS to actually customize it and pick the transition and all of that good stuff. From what I know, Twitch is also working on something like that, which means that you might even remove your vertical output. And if you never plan on recording or using the backtrack feature or the virtual camera, you can just turn those off. And now you have a way cleaner output. Okay. So if I want to go live now, I would go bow, bow, bow. And if I want to stop one particular stream before the other, I would just click on it again to stop the stream. And that's it. There you go. I removed the vertical too. There you go. That's what I meant. So you can keep it very simple. Built-in stream means that in your OBS settings, that's what you're logged into, right? So if in here in stream, you're logged into Twitch, this will be your built-in canvas, your main canvas, your built-in stream. If you are on YouTube already, then you would need to go to your output and actually add Twitch as your second stream, basically. So again, that's also a tab that you're not gonna fuss around with too much. So you can drop it on the controls. So boom, boom, boom. That way it's pretty clean. Oh, and of course, since you don't have the vertical thing anymore, you can pop your chat on the left. That way it's super duper clean. Maybe activity here. Hey, you decide. You decide your own, the best layout for yourself, okay? But yeah, I don't really multi-stream, but before that, my setup was really wonky. I had the Atom vertical plugin with the Atom multi-stream plugin, and I was using Streamlabs ground control to manage chat and the activities and also the stream info. And since ground control is its own thing, it was separate from OBS, it was a mess. But now I'm pretty happy that it's all under one roof. I really wish TikTok would make it easier to get a stream key though. There's a bunch of software with integrated multi-streaming. I might be trying those in the future. It all depends on how well this video does. Anyways, subscribe and thank you for watching.